Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy Cuban. In this video, we're continuing our journey with paginated reports and the paginated visual. This time, how do I send a date range as a parameter? Let's do it. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, we're going on this journey with paginated reports, the paginated visual inside of a Power BI report. And I talked before about looking at parameters, how do we wire them up, what values actually get passed to the paginated report. And so I want to actually see, how do I do this for a given date range? I've got a new requirement that I need to provide a range of dates, and I want to send that in the most efficient manner over to the paginated report. Let's take a look. All right, so we're back on my Power BI report. Just got a bar chart. We've got some slicers here, and you'll notice I've added a year slicer here so we can slice by year. So go look at 2021, and we can see our values for there by color, which is great. And then if we go over to our details report, we've got our paginated report here, and you'll notice that I've got this date filter that's on the page, and it's a complex filter, right? So I'm saying is on or after the first of 2021, and then is before the first of 2022. So I want to look at the whole year. I could also do this with a year filter where I say just the year is 2021, but I want to see what actually happens here. So if I just drag the calendar date table, so I've got a relationship here, so it should be date, and that's what I'm filtering on here. We talked before about the parameters that are going to be sent back. We can see here that it's on or after. That's my filter. And if I go to show as tables, what are the values that are going to be sent? And you're going to see here that we got a lot of dates that are being sent. And if we go back to our actual report, let's go to edit, sales report. I'll go ahead and turn order start on. We can actually choose date, and we can see here that this is a single value. So it's only going to pick a single date. This is not a multi-value parameter. If it was multi-value, you'd see comma separated list of dates. But Adam, why don't I just want to do that? I want multiple date ranges and I want to send that. Well, if you're sending a full year, that's potentially, depending on if it's a leap year or not, 365 days. That's 365 parameter values that you're sending to the paginated report. That's not efficient. What if you've got a 10-year range or a 5-year range? That's a lot bigger. And do we really want to send all those values? No, I want to send the start of the range and I want to send the end of the range. So how do we do that? And I kind of gave it away here, but let's go actually look at the paginated report. So the way we're going to do this is with an actual start and end in the paginated report. I've defined these. These have to be single value. Do not select multiple values here. And they have to be date time. I've gone ahead and put a default value just so I can run the report, but make sure this is a single value. Otherwise, this will not work. And then what I did is inside of my data set, I've got the parameters listed here. And in my query, I'm just doing a between. And so if there's other things you want to consider, you can modify your query to do that. So let's go back to the Power BI report. And if I just choose date, I can't choose date again. Now what do? I need a start and an end, but I only have one date, but it's the date that's being filtered. How does this work? This is where it gets cool. So what I'm going to do is this date, I'm going to say the earliest date, and then I'm going to put date in there again, and I'm going to choose the latest date. And so now what we see here is we can actually see earliest and latest in the dropdown. And so earliest is chosen, and then I'm going to choose latest date. And now we'll see it's the 1st through the 31st of December 2021, which is great. All right, so let's see the report. We'll go back to our show as table because this is what we can see what's actually being passed back. And you'll see there's only one date here and there's only one date here. Even though it's multiple times for those given combinations, it's only going to send one value for each, which is exactly what we want. And so now what I can do is if I muck around with these dates, I can even clear this and then let's see what our range is. Go to show as table. And then we can see here it's from 2011 to 2022. So let's go back to our report here. We're still on North America. America only. I'm not going to choose color and I'm going to choose 2021 in my year list. And then let's go and we'll do drill through details. Now we can see it chose black because I right clicked on black. It chose North America for the group and the year is 2021. So it's got filtered down. Let's go look at our table to see what values are going to be sent. And now it's doing it accordingly. So whether I have the complex filter in the filter pane or I'm passing it in from the year because I'm pulling off of the calendar table and this is, I can slice and dice how I'd like. This is all going to reflect the right value. So the key is you're going to add the date twice to the parameter list. One's going to be earliest, one's going to be latest. And then you're going to have single value parameters for a start and an end range, and then incorporate that into your actual query in the paginated report. bananas. This isn't in the documentation at all. I was working with a customer. I talked to some of the engineers on the engineering team, and they even said, oh no, this is how you do a date range. So I said, I'm doing a video on it. And here we are. All right, have you worked with dates or struggled with date ranges using a paginated report in the visual? Did this blow your mind? Let me know in the comments below. I wanna hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.